Hello, Professor Simpson, back again for Chapter 6, Section 2, Determining Empirical and Molecular Formulas. Once again, here are your learning objectives. Basically, three types of calculations we need to walk through here in this section: percentage composition, then empirical formula, and finally molecular formula. So let's start quickly with percentage composition, and this is the percentage by mass of each element in a compound. Percentage by mass of each element in a compound is the percentage percent composition. So basically, you're going to run into two types of problems here. You're going to run into those problems that are from experimental data, and also you're going to run into problems from a known formula. So let's first focus on from experimental data and take a look at this problem here. 10 gram sample of a compound is determined to contain 2.5 grams of hydrogen and 7.5 grams of carbon. So like any percentage that we're going to calculate, it's part over the whole. So if I wanted to calculate the percent of hydrogen in this particular compound, it would be 2.5 grams over the total mass of 10.0 grams. As always, we want a percentage, so we multiply it by 100, and I would get 25% hydrogen, and then the percent of carbon would be 7.5 grams over, again, the 10 gram total times 100 to get that 75% carbon. Just a fair warning here, be careful of the wording in the problem, like always, as we've been talking throughout the year. Really make sure you read it carefully to understand what exactly is the problem asking for and what data has it given me. They don't always give you the total. That would be something sometimes that you might have to sum. Also, you might have to determine the amount of one of the parts based on the data given in the problem. So just as you enter into a problem at the start, as always, take a second to identify those key components. The other type of percent composition problem is one from a known formula. In this case, we have NH3, ammonia here. So if we're using it from a known formula, we're going to take into account the atomic masses and the formula masses to determine those percent values. So if I were to look on my periodic table, I would see that nitrogen, and in this case, I have one atom of nitrogen. Thinking back to calculating the formula mass here, if I looked on the periodic table, the average atomic mass of nitrogen is 14.01. So the subtotal for nitrogen is 14.01. For hydrogen, we have three atoms of hydrogen, and the periodic table would tell me I have an average atomic mass of 1.008. Subtotal here would be 3.024. Sum those values to get my formula mass, 17.03. Now I can continue on with my percent composition calculation. So percent of nitrogen would equal the mass of nitrogen, in this case the 14.01, the atomic mass, divided by the molecular mass here, 17.03 times 100. Gives me a percentage of 82.27%. And then I would do the same thing for my hydrogen. And I would get the 17.76% for my percent of hydrogen. So percent composition, two types of problems here that you're going to run into: calculating the percent composition from a known formula, like I've shown you here, and then the first example was from some experimental data. Next, we're going to talk about determining the empirical formula. Now, I've given you a little flow chart here to help that process, but before we do that, let's just quickly talk about what an empirical formula is. So the empirical formula is the simplest whole number ratio of atoms in a compound. Simplest whole number ratio of atoms in a compound. So Here's a little flow chart on the process to determine the empirical formula. So we're going to get masses in a problem of our atoms. We're going to convert them to moles. Then we're going to divide both values by the smallest mole value, and then we'll get our ratio. So keep that flow chart in mind here, and let's jump into this first example. Compound is determined to contain 1.71 grams carbon and 0.287 grams of hydrogen. So as I said, or you see here, our first task here is to convert to moles. So 1 mole of carbon, atomic mass of carbon, 12.01 grams of carbon. I'm going to get a value here of 0.142 moles of carbon. Do the same thing for our hydrogen. Convert to moles, 1 mole of hydrogen, 1.008 grams. Again, from the average atomic mass from the periodic table. And I would get 0.284 moles of hydrogen. Okay, so once I've converted to moles, the next step here says divide by lowest number of moles. So exactly what I'm gonna do is I look at my two values here. My smallest mole value is the 0.142. So if I divide both of these by 0.142, what I'm gonna end up with are hopefully some whole number ratios here for our empirical formula. And you can see here, this value is gonna be 1, and here pretty nicely, I'm gonna get 2. So my empirical formula is 1 carbon atom and 2 hydrogen atoms, CH2. Okay, so I said right about here where we did our division in that step, I said hopefully we get nice whole number integers here, because as I said in the beginning, the definition, it's the simplest whole number ratio of atoms. And that worked out for this problem. It doesn't always work out so neatly. So let's take a look at this next example. Again, process is the same as always. You know, what is the problem asking for? What is the problem giving me? And then follow our plan through here. So this doesn't change. I'm going to start with 5.31 grams of chlorine and 8.40 grams of oxygen, excuse me. Do our conversion, 1 mole of chlorine, check my periodic table, 35.45 grams of chlorine, gives me a value of 0.150 mole of chlorine. Do the same thing for our oxygen, 1 mole of oxygen, 16.00 grams of oxygen. Going to give me a value of 0.525 mole of oxygen. Okay, so now we're at the step where we're going to divide our values. And again, these two examples, there are two atoms. You could have more than two, so the steps would be the same. I'm going to convert to moles. When I have all my mole values, I'm going to divide by the smallest mole value. In this case, it's the 0.150. And what happens here is we get our 1, but this is actually going to give us a value of 3.5. And so you haven't come across anything thus far that looks like that. And again, this is the empirical formula is the simplest whole number ratio of atoms. So that clearly doesn't work. But I can see here if I were to double both values, the 1 and the 3.5, I would get an empirical formula of Cl2O7. So the Cl2O7 gives me that simplest whole number ratio of atoms and ultimately my empirical formula. Basically, what I found out here is there is not a ratio here that works for chlorine and oxygen in which I only have 1 chlorine atom. The simplest that would be 2 chlorines and 7 oxygens. All right, let's wrap up this second section of chapter six by talking now about the molecular formula, determining the molecular formula. So this is the true or actual ratio of atoms in a compound. So it's a kind of a step beyond the empirical formula. So this example problem that I've put in here was kind enough to give you the empirical formula, but certainly this could be an extension of you having to solve for the empirical formula yourself. You're not always going to be lucky enough for them to give you the empirical formula here. They may ask for the molecular formula and give you the data that you saw in the empirical formula problems. So your first step is to determine the empirical formula and then take this last step beyond that, which I've given you shown you the formula for here. Basically, I need two pieces of information here. I need the molecular mass of this molecular formula we are hoping to obtain, and I need the empirical formula mass. So in this case, they've given me the empirical formula, so I've can quickly determine that for carbon, I have one carbon atom, 12.01. Just a quick formula mass calculation here, molecular mass calculation here, sorry, equals and our oxygen okay, and we will get our final value here for our atomic mass at 30.03. Okay, so you can see here that's the first stage I need. And again, as I mentioned in the beginning, they were nice enough to give me the empirical formula here. So I just needed to determine its formula mass. The other piece of information that I would need to be able to go from the empirical formula to the molecular formula is the molecular mass that we're looking for, of the molecular formula we're looking for. So now it's just a quick division of the 180 divided by the 30.03, and I get a value, an n value here of 6. So once I have my n value, you'll see the next step here is I can determine my molecular formula by multiplying each subscript by that n value. So that means this CH2O is going to be multiplied by 6, and I'm going to end up with a molecular formula of C6H12O6. Again, this can be all the way from the beginning. So where we're first asked to determine the empirical formula, given the data like the earlier problems I showed you, and then one additional step where now that you have the empirical formula, here's the molecular mass of the molecular formula we're looking for. We determine that n value and then multiply all our subscripts to go from the empirical formula to the molecular formula. Okay, that wraps up section two of chapter six. We calculated their percent composition and then worked to determine both the empirical formula and molecular formula.